a veteran police officer turned himself in earlier today after he was indicted for accidentally shooting and critically wounding a police trainee.
And tonight, the victim's attorney says he plans to file a civil suit against the Baltimore City Police Department. 11 News reporter George Lettis is live at City Police headquarters with the late-breaking details. George.
Well, Donna, this lawsuit will essentially blame city police leadership for this shooting. Meantime, the attorney for the indicted officer says today's charges and the evidence do not add up.
This is the first picture released of Raymond Gray since the 43-year-old University of Maryland Baltimore campus police recruit was accidentally shot in the face by a Baltimore City police training instructor. It happened last month during a training exercise at the former Rosewood Center in Owings Mills. Gray has been recovering at Sinai Hospital. His attorney, Dwight Pettit, says he just began walking and talking, and he will soon have surgery to replace the eye he lost during the incident.
Of course, he's blessed and very fortunate to be alive, but he has had a tremendous recovery. Mr. Gray indicates that he remembers nothing other than waking up in the hospital.
The instructor who pulled the trigger, William Kern, was indicted by a Baltimore County Grand Jury Wednesday. He's charged with misdemeanor second-degree assault and reckless endangerment, also a misdemeanor. Both could get him jail time. Kern's attorney tells 11 News, quote, "The fact that he was charged with second-degree assault doesn't fit with the allegations. Assault requires showing of intent. This case is a tragedy. It's a tragic accident that was unintentional. We look forward to our day in court to demonstrate his innocence," unquote. Kern's attorney also says the evidence in the case does not support a reckless endangerment charge either, and that Kern continues to be concerned for the well-being of Gray. As the criminal case unfolds, Gray's attorney announced that in about a month, he'll file a civil suit against Baltimore City Police for what he calls the department's gross negligence with the training exercise. Commanders did not know the Rosewood Center was being used by city instructors for an exercise that was not supposed to include live weapons. 11 News I-Team sources say Kern kept his with him and mistakenly grabbed it and fired while trying to scare Gray away from a window.
And you don't have multiple safeguards to make sure those weapons have been secured, to make sure they have been checked and rechecked, to make sure they have been unloaded, to make sure the bullets have been seized, and you have nothing in place to do that.
Now, in a statement tonight, City Police Commissioner Anthony Batts says in part, quote, "When we fall short, we will not only hold ourselves accountable, but we'll take the necessary time, care, and caution required to restore the public's confidence in our department," end quote. Now, Officer William Kern, who is still suspended with pay, was released after his bail hearing today. We're live at City Police Headquarters. George Lettis, WBAL-TV 11 News.